Sharma, Ms. Misra, ladies and gentlemen, members of the press, it's a frightening evening for me. Seriously. You see, Chandigarh Literary Society, I had to rehearse 10 times before I came here. I had to say Chandigarh Literary Society, Chandigarh Literary Society, Chandigarh Literary Society. I was fumbling. So now I said it right, so I'm feeling better. I don't know why they have chosen me as their first speaker or first meet the author kind of a thing. There are two, three things. One is that they thought maybe we should all call people from alphabetical order. Anupam Kher. So that really can be one of the reasons. Then I have a feeling that they chose the guest of honor first, which was Mr. Sharma. So then they thought that how do we make Mr. Sharma comfortable? Let's choose an author who has the same hairstyle. Then in that sense you have done a great job, ma'am. In fact, both of us have 17 here in the middle. 18, sir. So that is why. So I have a feeling that this is how they chose me. And then they did the most frightening thing, they all spoke before me. So now they are relaxed. Mr. Sharma has spoken. Ms. Misra has spoken, and इन्होंने तो दो तीन शेर सुना दिए. मैंने भी एक शेर लिखा था. एक ही शेर लिखा था जिंदगी में. उसके बाद मेरे पिताजी ने वो किताब जला दी. Because he thought I was talking about mine and his future. I wrote in about 11th standard. I'm from a Hindi medium school. कि सोचा था जिंदगी में हम भी बन दिखलाएंगे कुछ. बकवास है शेर वैसे, पर आप बाबा कर रहे हैं. सोचा था हम भी जिंदगी में हम भी बन दिखलाएंगे कुछ, कुछ बनने के ही चक्कर में रह गए, बन ना पाए कुछ. सो दैट वाज अ नाइटमेयर फॉर माय फादर. कि ये तो अभी से लिख रहा है कि कुछ बन नहीं पाए. बट इट्स आई थिंक इट्स व्हेन आई एम इनवाइटेड टू अ चंडीगढ़ लिटरेरी सोसाइटी. Then I feel that I have made it big in life. It makes me feel very proud of how I have. It makes me feel proud of my journey that I have taken up. My journey started from your neighboring town, Simla. In 1955, I was born, 7th of March. And to a clerk in the forest department. So fine, I wanted to be an actor. I worked very hard for that. And I ran away from home, came to Chandigarh. My first audition was in Chandigarh. And I did not have money to come to Chandigarh. And I did not want to tell my parents that I'm going for the audition. So I stole 100 rupees from my mother's temple. And sometimes theft does work. And I came with my friend from Chandigarh, Bombay, apna Simla to Chandigarh. It was a 4-hour journey. I went to the Department of Drama, Department of Indian Theatre. Mr. Balwant Gargi was the head of the department there. What I wanted to do, they gave me some 2-3 pieces for the audition. And I chose the piece which was basically chosen for women, for female actors and actresses. So I said, Rani ji is here. Rani was my teacher at that time. She still remains my teacher. Thank you, Rani, for being in the audition and selecting me. So I chose this piece of Vasant Sena. I said, they are not going to judge me by my acting. They are going to judge me by my guts. And when I went back, I did not tell my parents, my mother. There was a huge hue and cry in my house. The reason was that somebody had stolen 100 rupees from the temple. It was a big issue for my mother, and my mother kept looking at me and she said, where had you gone? I said, I had gone for a picnic. And about 7-8 days later, my father called me and he says, where did you actually go there that day? So I said, now everybody knows where I had gone. So I said, I had gone for the audition to be an actor. My mother said, where did you get money to go there? So I had to admit, and I said, I had stolen 100 rupees from your temple mom. So I got one tight slap from my mother. But my father said, okay, don't slap him. He's going getting 200 rupees as a stipend to be the student, and he will give you 100 rupees out of that. That was on 17th of July 1974, I left Simla. But more than that, what I must tell you, what happened today. I was shooting at ISBT, this interstate bus terminal in Chandigarh. And it put me to flashback. Before I joined Department of Indian Theatre, I had gone for the audition at the National School of Drama. And that was on the 3rd of May 1974. I was rejected the first time I went there. And there was a train strike those days, on that particular day. So we had reached early, and me and another friend of mine who is still here in the audience, Satish, I slept on a newspaper near a pillar where the tickets were sold, and today I was shooting at the same place. So the journey is again beautiful, and it made me feel, when you clap, you're clapping for an actor, not for an author. So please clap properly. give me a rehearsal, please. You see, it's not an author turned actor, it's an actor turned author. For 28 years, I'm used to clapping, then only my dialogues come out. So, and don't be apologetic about clapping. You're applauding me, then applaud with heart, as he said that it has to come from heart. So anyway, yes. Or I can make it easy for you. Every time I raise my hands, you can clap. So what I'm trying to say is that it's a brilliant feeling, not only of achievement, but also in the belief that in life, kuch bhi ho sakta hai. Never did I think on that day, on the 3rd of May 1974, when I was sleeping on that newspaper, and I was sitting and I was talking to him, and that many years later, I'll be shooting for a film there at the same place, and I went and clicked a picture there, and it made me have a belief in my own beliefs, in my own capabilities, in my own optimistic attitude. I'm a very optimistic person. I'm a greatly optimistic person. And from there, to finish my shooting for that film, to come here and talk to the people who are absolutely, and I'm not saying it with being any modesty, who are much more educated than I am, and you are actually looking up at me, it's a great achievement. And it has nothing to do with me writing a book. The book came out of my life. That's why it touches everybody's heart. I'm also thankful to Mr. Ashok Chopra of Hay House Publishers, the way they have put this book together. The credit goes to Mr. Chopra. Can you just stand up so that they acknowledge you? Again, there's another amazing coincidence. Mr. Chopra was the first person to write a review of my play in a play in Chandigarh, in a newspaper, and that was the review which I still have with me. Two reviews I still have with me. One is Mr. Chopra's review and one is Mr. Khwaja Ahmed Abbas's review. And both of them wrote that this is an actor to watch out for. Theek angrezi boli, watch out for? Sahi kya hai? Sahi hai? Fantastic. So that's Anji, Three Penny Opera and Exceptional, Three Penny Opera. So when you encounter such thing, we are talking about how to feel good about ourselves. You were talking about, Mr. Sharma, that there are times when you feel good about it and there are times when you don't feel good about it. The courage is to feel good about it when you're not feeling good about yourself. How do you feel good about yourself? I'll keep going forward and backwards in my conversation because I don't prepare my speeches. I can't be presumptuous about this is what you want to hear. I have always felt good about myself.
Because I think that was the only way to lead life. I also always say that when you're poor, happiness is the cheapest thing that comes in your way. Because if you're poor, you're happy. And especially in those times, when being happy was a luxury of anybody who was not a thinking person. Small town, my parents did not know what I was studying. My mother is an educated, uneducated lady, very worldly wise. My father was too busy in earning money for both the morning meals and the evening meals. So, but we lived in an atmosphere which was a happy atmosphere. Which we lived in an atmosphere which only had to look forward to the next good thing happening to your life. So anything was good and we were not greedy. I don't think I'm still greedy. The problem is in ourselves that we always feel underachievers as compared to other people. We always compare our life, we have a reference point. I remember I went to city of Bombay on the 3rd of June 1981. Why I remember the dates? Because they are historical for me. I always thought I will make it one day and I will have to quote the dates. Because I had no alternate, I had to make it. So I remember 3rd of June 1981, I landed in Bombay with 37 rupees. Because I was doing a job in Lucknow, and by the time I finished with that, I came to Bombay because somebody had promised me a job in Bombay, but I had 37 rupees. So when I compare my life and my graph, I will always be a millionaire as compared to 37 rupees. So then I will always be happy about it. But if I started thinking why am I not Bradley Cooper or why am I not Brad Pitt, or why I'm not even Mr. Bachchan, I'll be unhappy with being Anupam Kher. But how many people can make it the way Anupam Kher has made it? And it has nothing to do with public perception. You don't have to be famous and known. You have to be a person who believes in what he or she is doing. You can be anybody. You can be Mr. Malhotra, Mrs. Malhotra, Mr. Sachdeva, Mrs. Sachdeva. You can be Neelam, you can be Neha, you can be Rakesh, you can be anybody. As long as you don't think that you are the face in the crowd, the world will not think like that. But if you think that you are a face in just a crowd, then the world will treat you like that. I never thought that I was a face in the crowd. I never wanted to wear a wig after I made it and got into movies. My first thing my manager, my secretary told me, sir, aap wig pehen lijiye. Maine kaha, kyun pehen lunga? Kaha, aapne aaj tak koi bina baal ka hero dekha hai? So, aap dekhenge ab mere ko, aisi kya baat hai? He said, nahi, nahi. So, I broke this whole myth of, I was 27 when I did Saransh, 65-year-old man's role. So, then people said, oh, all your life you will be now stuck with this kind of a role. But I said no. So I tried to break this myth of typecasting. I picked up a role of Dr. Dang, Thappad Ki Goonj, or anything, because I had the conviction of my own beliefs. It's our own beliefs when we sort of feel shaky about that we don't remain the kind of person we are. I always believe that the personality is something which makes you comfortable within yourself, that you are comfortable in your skin. That is personality, because then you are yourself. Why do you like somebody suddenly? It's not only because, not only because you have praised the person, because that person is being himself or herself. There is something you find endearing about that person. And why is, but unfortunately, in today's time, what we are trying to do, we are trying to be constantly wanting to be somebody else. Because we are unhappy with ourselves. Unhappy means we feel that this is not sufficient. I should be somebody else. It's not only your fault, it's also the fault of the marketing. Today, marketing has become everything. Today, you are constantly made to feel underachievers. Today, it happened to me also for a long time. Every day I wanted to see my photographs in newspapers. Every day I was wanting to be the most happening person. Till I one day realized that I must be happening for myself. I can't depend on whether people will manipulate. If you place your happiness in somebody else's hand, they will make sure that you are unhappy. Because they are also half-hearted about themselves. That's why when you want, when you see, when you show somebody your achievements, you actually are showing them a mirror. They have only two alternates. One is to praise you, one is to criticize you. Because what they see in the mirror, they don't like it. So they will say, "Arey, paise khaye honge. Arey, kuch iske saath aisa kiya hoga. Ye aisa kiya." Hamare yahan main hamesha is baat ke bare mein bolta hu that in our 4x4 Naba house, that is my address in Simla, that used to be my address, my family for a change was the first family which got black and white TV. So it was a big thing. Everybody in the evening used to come and watch this thing till Mr. Malik got a colored TV. We suddenly lost our importance because the whole neighborhood started going to Mr. Malik's this thing. And my father was very sweet. He said, "Tu used to sell me and my brother. Tum bhi jaakar wahi dekh lo." So it's a very basic thing. It's a very small little basic thing that can make your happiness a little little, you know, unhappy. There's an element of unhappiness will come. If you get up in the morning, it's a very simple thing. You have to practice happiness. Happiness is something to be practiced. It cannot happen on your own. You have to decide, "I want to be happy." Because you get up in the morning and you see somebody's face and he is not shaved or he is not very bright, so it spoils your mood. You go outside, the guy outside has not done some namaste to you properly, it spoils your mood. You get into the car, the driver is in a bad mood, it spoils your mood. You get into the office, you thought you were looking best, but the person did not give you compliment, it spoils your mood. So you are ready to spoil your mood at any given pretext. You're waiting when to get spoiled. Mera mood kyun nahi kharab ho raha, 15 minute ho gaye. 15 minute ho gaye, abhi tak mood kharab nahi hua. Puri baat ko mere bare mein. I am not dependent on that. So many times I have told my driver, Sabir, when I get not right vibes from him, I said, "Stop the car, let's get out of the car. Let's get into a frame of mind that both of us are happy. Problem kya hai?" So he will say, "Dey, mera biwi se jhagda ho gaya." Usually that is the problem. So both of us get at the same time out of the car. One day Sabir told me, "Aap bhi gaadi se utro, sir." Problem kya hai? Maine kaha, biwi se jhagda ho gaya. So if you decide that you will not let somebody spoil your mood, you'll be a happy man. It's as simple as that. If you decide that I am earning this much money, so you are looking after your kids, you are looking after your... I was very saddened today. I met somebody and she said to me that my parents are very old and I'm basically living with them because both my brother and my sister are living abroad. So my parents are very lonely. We decided, not that we were offered to go to any foreign country, but we never wanted to get out of this country. We never feel it because I think the best thing that can happen to you is your parents. That is the most important thing. And I'm not saying it just because of it. It's just because I have to say it. The parents are the people that we take for granted the most. They are slowly, slowly becoming furniture park. This is the seventh time you yawned, man. There is a problem with that corner. It is not your fault. The lady next to you is also 11 times, man. I was not speaking, Mrs. Misra was speaking. The only time you did not yawn when Mr. Sharma was speaking. So I thought maybe you're related to him or something like that. But maybe this portion has lack of oxygen. I'm very entertaining. I'm not going to let my happiness go ruined by your yawning. Now the onus is on you. You better not yawn now. Pani pilao, madam. So these are also, if you are yourself, it can be the best thing that can happen to you. We are petrified of being ourselves. But the best thing that has happened to you is being yourself. When you are yourself, you don't have to be somebody else. Because you are yourself. Whether you can speak in English, whether you can have the right pronunciation. Kiran is MA first class first. Her English is impeccable. मैं DAV स्कूल का पढ़ा हुआ फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड मैंने ABCD सीखी है मतलब इट वाज हिलेरियस व्हेन आई वाज वंस आस्क्ड टू गिव अ स्पीच वेलकम स्पीच इन ऑनर ऑफ प्रिंसेस दुर्गावती ऑफ लखनपुर प्रिंसेस दुर्गावती ऑफ लखनपुर वाज द प्रिंसेस ऑफ आवर स्टेट नेक्स्ट टू शिमला एंड शी वाज एवरी ईयर शी यूज्ड टू बी द चीफ गेस्ट ऑफ आवर स्कूल बिकॉज शी वाज द प्राइम डोनर So even when she was 97, she was the chief guest. So, and my principal, Professor Satya Prakash, knew that I was desperate to speak in English. Because I was the only person who used to say good morning to him. The rest of the students were, Namaste ji, Namaste sir, kya hal hai sir, Namaste. I used to say good morning sir. So, unhone mujhe ek din apne kamre mein bulaya. Unhone kaha, beta, is bar maine decide kiya hai. You will be the person who will give a speech in honor of Princess Durgavati. So I said, maybe I'm the fairest guy in the class, so that's why I'm chosen. But then he said, I have decided that you will have to speak in English. I said, sir, are you suicidal? How can I speak in English? He said, don't worry. Main tereko speech aaj de deta hun. Tu ghota laga le. Memorize your lines. And on the day of the thing, you can give the speech. And my another uncle, who was the first graduate in our 100 years of family, he used to take that very seriously. He used to use big words to demoralize us and my father. But we used to get very entertained. He will say, torrential rains have fallen onto the earth and the earth lava is coming out and something. So we thought that Russian mein bol rahe. So my principal was one side, he gave me a speech in honor of Princess Durgavati of Lakhanpur. And my chacha said, Angrezi jo hai, you can learn English by reading the editorials of the newspapers. So Tribune was the only paper those days. So he used to give me one editorial to remember by heart. So I was remembering the editorial by heart and I was remembering the speech by heart. And for some strange coincidence, as the day of the convocation of the prize distribution, they were getting mixed. And I was hoping that life will take its own course and it will get segregated. Now, this is slightly an exaggeration of the speech, but I must share it with you. So the speech that I actually gave on the day of Princess Durgavati of Lakhanpur was something like this, which was a mixture of things. Exaggeration, but a good one. Ladies of the gentlemen, I should have understood a few homogeneous words in kind condolence of Princess Durgavati of Lakhanpur. The infection of the great constipation in the large intestine of mankind, which is being spread in pregnancy by her flirting excellency. That is why I am shivering in high frequency. Her divine grace is a mental case, so I will pay my last homage to Her Highness with great amount of shyness that you came into our school. That is God's nature. Sometimes I look at you, sometimes my furniture. I don't know whether it happened because of my speech, but my principal had a heart attack and after 7 days, Princess Durgavati of Lakhanpur passed away. But I never gave up speaking in English. My father's senior was Mr. Malhotra. He was a very sadistic person. His son was also my class fellow. And his father, Mr. Malhotra, knew that I was a duffer. I never got more than 38% marks. But still, he will want to humiliate me in front of my father. So he will ask me very difficult questions because he will see whether his son is more intelligent or I am more intelligent. His son is working in an electricity board now. But God is great. So he used to always ask me, once I was playing cards, he said, oh, so you gamble? I said, yes, I am gamble. So he used to say, so I had no intellectual problem of having the luxury of feeling depressed. Depression, sadness is an intellectual's luxury. I'm a thinking man, so I am depressed. Dil nahi lag raha yaar. Kuch achha nahi lagta yaar. Matlab they will become asthmatic. There will be one more drink, I think, for the road, for the kitchen, for the this. Dil nahi lag raha yaar. Sad. वो गालिब ने एक शेर कहा है, अरे गालिब ने नहीं कहा था कि डिप्रेस हो जाओ. सो डिप्रेशन इज अप टू यू. यू गेट, यू से दैट आई गेट डिप्रेस्ड. सो हु हैज आस्क्ड यू टू गेट डिप्रेस्ड? यू कैन मूव आउट, रन, स्पीक टू अ स्ट्रेंजर, यू विल फील बेटर. माय ग्रैंडफादर यूज्ड टू से दिस, हैप्पीनेस एंड सैडनेस इज इन योर हैंड्स. यू कैन फील वेरी हैप्पी बाय थिंकिंग हाउ मेनी पीपल आर बेटर देन, सैड, वर्स देन यू. एंड यू कैन फील वेरी sad, I think I spoke ulta. You can feel very sad by thinking how many people are better than you, but you can feel very happy by how many people are worse than you. And people who are worse than you will always be much in numbers. So I am, when I'm traveling, I'm looking at my boy who has been working with me for the last 25 years, 27 years. He's a happy person. I'm surrounded by people who have to be happy. That's my condition. Whether you are PhD or you are even in my office, I only employ, first thing is, how is his smile? Does he smile often? Does his smile reach his eyes? I'm not looking what you have done. You were the CEO of so and so company. Or you can be the CEO of company, but you will make me unhappy about it. I also have people who are unbelievably optimistic, who are constantly talking about optimism. So I surround myself by people who are optimistic. Now you say that things, that doesn't mean that I don't get sad, I don't get upset, it doesn't demoralize me. Of course I do feel. My film does not do well, or I'm not praised, or some critic has criticized myself, but I've learned the art of being happy. So, and it's the, you don't have to pay any attention to any self-help books, including mine, because life is the best book that you can read. It's the only thing that we ignore life. We exist, we don't live. We are existing from day to day, every day. We are living on a daily basis. Or we are living in the basis of future, this thing. Aage kya hoga? We are either worrying about past, or we are, no, this is not something great that I am telling you that you have to live in present. But the practicality of it is that we don't live in the present. And we spend too much time and too much energy in talking about others. Because that's become a national pastime. We constantly do that. Coming back to books, how books helped me. My first book was Maxim Gorky's Mother. Now we'll say that if I was, those days, the Russian, there were translations of Indo-Soviet books. Yeah. That lot of books were translated from Russian to English and Russian to Hindi. So my first book was presented to me by the same uncle, the only graduate, called Ma. Mother, Maximum Gorky's. I was, I think, in 9th standard. I started reading it and I found, wow, there are so many people I know in the book, in the sense that I know Pavlov, I know Olga, oh, this is her life, this is what. It expanded my imagination to a great extent. And I started living in a world of my own. For when you're reading a book, everybody has an interpretation of the person or of the scenario that you're reading. On a dark wintry night, the man with the hat was walking alone. He stood under the lamp post, lit a cigarette and walked continuously. Now, I have said these four lines. Everybody sitting over here has its own dark wintry night. Everybody has the person who is wearing a different hat, and the cigarette brand is also different, hopefully. So that is what the magic of books is. Magic of books gets you into a world which makes you feel richer, which makes you feel, because when you see the same book, why do we get disappointed at the film adaptation of a book? Because our imagination was richer somewhere than the imagination that you saw. So it disappoints you. I saw Clark Gable like this, or I saw so and so person in a different scenario. I saw a different knight. There's a big beautiful short story. It's the shortest short story. It's an Egyptian or a Persian short story. It's about a man who sends his servant to get something from the market and meet him in the next village. So it is an amazing world of books. I used to go behind Jama Masjid. There was people used to sit on the floor. There used to get books from all over. I have found the most unbelievable books in those street things. Raddi wale aate the, koi nayi kitabe le jaate the. A lot of my great or good performances have a lot to do with my books, because even James Hadley Chase helped me a lot. Ved Prakash Kamboz, from Ibn Safi. You know, these are the kind of Gulshan Nanda. No, I'm not talking about Jaishankar Prasad and Mulk Raj Anand or something like that. Any kind of reading will always elevate you in your own eyes. That is the best thing about books. So when I... Thank you. So when I talk about my life, it has to be along with the books. So when I wrote this book, it is an accident. I'm an accidental author. I did not plan to write a book. My play gave me a platform to be a motivational speaker, because the play I did on my life was about my love, about my failures, about my disasters, about my shortcomings. Another thing, when you tell people what you are actually in situation, then people can't frighten you. Right now, my left leg is bigger than my right leg. Now you will not be able to frighten me. My English is not as impeccable as it should be. You can't frighten me. I went bankrupt 10 years back in my company. Now you can't frighten me anything. So if I say all my problems to you, what will you frighten me with? Nothing. I'm superior to all of you. So the problem is we hide ourselves. And if you don't see yourself in any trait as a shortcoming, how can the world see it as a shortcoming? Baldness is the best thing that has happened to me. I would have not got Saransh if I was not bald. This is a very dignified, sexy look. And Mr. Sharma will agree with me. More than Mr. Sharma, it is Mrs. Sharma who will agree with me. Unki aankhon mein ek chamak hai is samay. So, what I'm trying to say, be yourself. It is, so the book came out of I was called for motivational lectures to all the universities which I could not even pronounce. Till now, I thought Kellogg was only a cornflakes key to this thing. I swear I'm not joking. Till I turned out to be the best business school in the world. In Chicago. I was invited there for lecture. Another bald gentleman. Well done. मतलब अगर मुझे कहीं शीशा ना मिले मैं अपनी कोपड़ी में देख सकता हूँ अपने आप को. किरण जी मिली थी आपको? आप मुझे जलाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं? Sorry यार, माफ कर दो. मैंने आपकी चमकते बात के ऊपर कुछ कहा, पर किरण जी का जिक्र तो मत लाइए ना. किरण जी मिली थी मुझे. किरण जी किसी को नहीं मिलती है. So I was called to these places for motivational lectures. And what was I talking about? My life. What was I talking about? What I learned from my life. To be myself. To talk about failure, that the failure is the best thing that can happen to you. Failure is the best thing that can happen to you. You need to take it in the right spirit. Failure is very attractive if you do not indulge in self-pity. Success is one-dimensional. I always say, if you come first, the onus is on you. You have to come first every time. I used to come 57th. So I could go 56th, 54th, 38th. I had a journey which was always upwards. So that's how I looked at it.
एक शेर सुनाता हूँ सर. उम्र भर अपने ही गिरेबां से उलझने वाले, तू मुझे मेरे ही साये से डराता क्या है.
So from that the book came, and I get very comically amused when I'm introduced as a best-selling author. मैंने ज़िंदगी में कभी नहीं सोचा था. And they will say, okay, winner of 8 Filmfare awards, not 5. Okay. Winner of so-and-so, national awards about acting, this and that. I worked with Robert De Niro recently. I was very thrilled, etc., etc. But never in my wildest dreams I thought that I will one day write a book and it will actually become a bestseller. My publisher kept telling me that to have 25,000 copies in 2 months is phenomenal. So I think he's in the business when he is. To have the 8th reprint in 2 months is amazing. So, because I'm not trying to dwarf you by my knowledge of life. I'm not even telling you how to be happy. I'm not even telling you how to be peaceful. I'm not even telling you how to be successful. I am only telling you through this, be yourself. That is the best thing that has happened to you. Thank you very much.